Hey, Luke here. Just wanted to put together a quick video over a recent DBA challenge that I posted on LinkedIn. This was on day 24, and the scenario was you're a DBA and you've just started a new job and are getting familiar with the database setup. You find a large database with several file groups. One of those file groups is named indexes, and according to a developer, it should only contain non-clustered indexes. The challenge was specifically, you need to find out what objects are actually stored in the indexes file group, and then determine if it's being used correctly as per the intended design. This demo will just take you through setting up a quick database. I used ChatGPT to generate all of the code that we're going to use to create this database, putting some tables in the primary file group and then a few over into the indexes file group so that we can use an example query. This is a query that I'll typically use if I'm presented with this scenario. So I'm going to go ahead and switch over to the demo machine. And we'll go ahead and start it up. I'm just using my sandbox, and we're going to go ahead and spin up one of my machines. This has SQL Server 2022 Developer Edition installed, and we're running it on Windows Server 2022 Evaluation Edition. Let me go ahead and sign back in as the correct user. And we'll go ahead and bring up Management Studio. And we'll connect to SRV2. If you're interested in catching these DBA challenges, I'm posting those daily on LinkedIn. And then weekly, I put together a newsletter of some of the most popular challenges for that week. Usually that's going by the number of comments made. I'll put a link down below where you can sign up for that newsletter. And then also, if you want to check it out on LinkedIn, just search for either my name, Luke Campbell, or you can search for DBA challenges, the hashtag. Let's see what's going on. SQL Server's not, didn't start. So let's go ahead and start it. All right, we have only got one database here. So we're gonna create a database, just named it File Group Demo. And we'll go ahead and just open up these three scripts. The first one we're going to use is just going to be used to create the database. I'm just going to make sure that I've already got the SQL data folder out here, and I do. So it's going to create the MDF. Of course, that's going to be your primary file group with a size of 4 megabytes, and then the file growth is 256. And then we're going to create our indexes file group. It's only going to contain one file. And we'll set that to 256 file growth as well. And then, of course, your transaction log file. So let's go ahead and create this. All right, we should refresh over here and we'll have our database. Yep, file group demo. And if we take a look at the properties, files, we'll see that we have one file in the primary file group, one in the indexes, and then our transaction log file. So go ahead and click OK on that. And we'll switch over to our schema script. And then I asked ChatGPT just to create example schema based on a typical CRM database with placing some of these tables and indexes in the indexes file group and then some in the primary file group. Go ahead and run that, and then we'll see if our tables are here, and they are. One quick way, of course, you wouldn't want to do this if you were looking at hundreds of tables or indexes. You'd want to script it, but I'll show you that in a second. But if you were to right click on one of these tables and go to properties, go to storage, and you can see right here the file group where it resides. But we're not going to do it that way. We're going to use a script. Let's go ahead and just load a bit of data in here. Here again, I just had ChatGPT generate this just so that we can load a few tables. Not all of them are being populated. Let's go make sure. No, we're not supposed to use select star, but we're doing a demo. All right, so we've got some example data here. And now we can switch over and use this script, which uses the data in the file groups, system table, indexes, partitions, and objects. If you check out the link to the newsletter below, you'll see a definition of each one of those system tables. Let's go ahead and run this. And now this gives us the schema name. So we didn't set up multiple schemas here, but if we did, you would see those here. Object name, so this is our accounts table. And then we can see that it's a clustered index. And of course, the clustered index and the table will always reside in the same file group. And we can see that this one is in the primary file group. If we go down to line 4, we can see the call logs has an index inside the indexes file group. And for our scenario, that's exactly what we want to see. But you can see here that our invoices table resides in the indexes file group. So we would have to, we're not going to cover it in this demo, but we would need to determine a way that we can move that index and that table to the primary file group. In this case, it is a primary key, so you couldn't just recreate the index like you would with drop online equals on and then move it that way. You would actually have to remove the primary key and then recreate it by specifying the new file group. And then in doing so, that will move the table and, of course, the clustered index with it. There's other considerations. If you've got foreign keys that's referencing that primary key, you would have to, of course, think through all the repercussions of dropping that primary key. But again, we're not covering that today. Just wanted to show you how you can identify which file groups are being used and by which objects. So that's it. I'll just put a link to this query. I'll put a link to the newsletter post, this edition of the newsletter, and it's included in there. Be sure to check out the associated LinkedIn post and all the comments there. There's several other scripts that can be used for this. I know Jeff Moden, he has contributed a script in one of the comments that also adds a few other system views that you can use to actually pull back the row count and the size of the object. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.